Tori Hornsby here with Tesla Tips and Tricks. Today, we're gonna be working on my Model X performance here in our Tesla Tips and Tricks corporate office in Peachtree City, Georgia. We're gonna be addressing a well-known issue with the Model X's, and so we'll break down the three-step process that most service centers use, which is complaint, cause, correction. You get the complaint from the customer, you define the cause of the issue, and then you perform the correction. So the complaint is that the inside edge of the tire on the rear wears out very, very fast. And so what is the cause of this? Well, this is often misdiagnosed, but I'm gonna get down here and see if you guys can see this. So I've got my Tesla, it's on the high setting, and so you can't see it quite as bad, but the camber of the wheel is how much it sticks out from the bottom. If it's outside, it's negative camber. If it's inside, it's positive camber. Vehicles with independent rear suspension, like a lot of Teslas have, are very well known for having negative camber, and that's a problem. And the issue with this is the lower it gets, the more that it squats down, the more negative camber there is, and therefore you're not putting your power to all, you know, 10 and a half inches, 11 inches of your tread. You're only putting it to that inch and a half, 2 inch corner of the tire, which is why it wears out so fast, especially with these high performance models, the performance, the plaid models. That's a lot of torque and horsepower that you're putting down to a small strip of tire. And then it just rides on that a lot more too. As you can see, I'm on very high and you can still see that the bottom of the tire is sticking out. Now the toe of the tire is what people often misdiagnose this as, in that the toe is how far the wheel is sticking to the left or to the right. So basically which direction it's aiming to where the camber is this way. So this is a negative camber issue. The correction for this is to replace the camber arm with an adjustable camber arm. So you can see this goes on the top of the vehicle, I'll show you in a second, and allows you to adjust in and out to the top of the tire, thereby making it to where instead of having negative camber, you can make it to where it's a 90 degree perpendicular to the ground on your low suspension setting. So you can never make it perfect with independent rear suspension at every setting because the wheel is, as it goes up and down, it's doing so on a circumference. And so it can never be perfectly flat all the time, but you wanna get it adjusted to where it is at your low vehicle setting, your normal ride is flat, is perpendicular, all of the tread is even with the ground. Now, for those of you who are asking, wait, you gotta replace it with a aftermarket part to fix this? Like, what the heck? Like, why doesn't Tesla have a correction for this? I don't know. I don't know. I've wondered the same thing, but they don't. So the first step towards working on your Tesla and jacking it up is to put it in jack mode. So we'll step inside my office here. I'm a little cheesy like that sometimes. And the way that you put it into jack mode, I'll get close here, is you tap on the vehicle, you go into service, and then you hit jack mode. Now, it was already on for me. So if it's blue, it's on. I had actually activated it before I started the camera. So you go to service, then you go to jack mode. If that's blue, the car is ready to be lifted up. And that's important because now all of the sensors and the monitoring systems aren't wondering what's going on as you lift the car up off the ground. It knows that you're planning something. You put it in jack mode. The next step here, this is very important too. The bottom of these cars is a battery. And so you want to be sure that you protect the battery, most importantly, but also the plastic pieces down here. You want to be sure you protect those. And the way that you do that when you're jacking up a Tesla is with a puck. Now, the corners of the cars here up front, and then on the other side up front, and same place on the other side, there's a piece of plastic with three holes in it where this puck inserts in so that you can jack it up. Let me see if I can get a look at that here. Here is this plastic. You can see the three holes, and this just simply inserts right up into it. And now you would jack it from that point, and this 1 inch of rubber protects the plastic, the trim, the battery from being damaged. So I'm gonna get this car lifted up and I'll be right back with you. So I've got the jack positioned here with the puck ready to lift up all the way. But before I lift it up all the way, I want to loosen the lug nuts with a breaker bar, and this will make it a lot easier when the vehicle is still on the ground, but there are these lug nut covers. And so you can see they have a little lip on them. There's a tool that you can get from Amazon or many of the Tesla accessory sites that is like a pair of tweezers, and it clips onto the corners and you just pull it off like a pair of tweezers. But with this lip, you can really use anything as long as you're careful. Here I've got this is ironic. It's a spark plug gap tool. So I'm repurposing my spark plug gap tool from my drag racing days to get these covers off. And the way you do it is you just put it in flat on either side, turn them in to catch that lip, and you just pull it off. So they come off easy, but you do want to do that. So I'm going to get the wheel off, I'm going to get the car jacked up, and we'll be right back with you. This is the camber arm that connects to the frame right up here. Let me change arms. So it connects from here, and it's this arm that goes all the way right here and then connects to the assembly right here, the wheel assembly right there. So you can see to where if this arm was adjustable, you could make the top of the wheel stick out a little more to make the tire even. We're also going to be replacing, because you have to, if you adjust this, you have to be able to adjust the toe. So we're going to be replacing this toe arm as well. So I'm going to get these loosened up, and then I'll be right back. So now that I've got the bolts loosened there, the next step is to take off this bar right here. So this system actually monitors the height of the car, reports back to the vehicle how high the car is. So we need to just pop this plastic piece off of the nipple that's on the camber arm. And that's a pretty simple thing to do. Just simply put a screwdriver on either side and just gently pry it off, and it just pops right off there. So now we've got the camber arm out, and we're going to take this off. By the way, the tools needed for that are an 18. It's very, very helpful to have a gear wrench of some sort because of the tight space in there. So you need an 18, you need a 19, and you need a 15. And then you want to have those sockets available as well, 15, 18, and then 19. And then, oh, by the way, 10 millimeter takes off the bracket for the suspension monitoring. So that's a 10 millimeter back there. And then the only 19 millimeter nut is this one back here. And this is for the tow arm. So we're gonna get that removed, and then we'll go back in with the new one once we get this suspension monitoring nipple taken off and added on to the new one. I'm gonna use a little thread locker on this just to be sure that little nut doesn't come off. And now the hardest part of this job. This bolt right here doesn't come out because it's blocked by the frame. Some people report that you can get it out. That's what we're gonna hope for. We're gonna hope to be able to do that. But if not, then what we're going to have to do is cut this bolt. So I'm going to set the camera up where you can watch. So I have tried to finagle this bolt enough to be able to get it out, but it's just not going to come out without lowering the drive unit, which is what the service manual says to do. So what people do is they cut it. And so that's what we're gonna be doing. I have here a Bauer, a Harbor Freight Special. I like it because there is the unit and it's just on this this hose, and it makes it pretty easy to access things. So what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna cut this bolt right here, just cut it around and keep on spinning it until I can get it off. I'll be back. So we got our tow arm out and we had to cut the head of the bolt off. And it's important, since you're gonna ruin that bolt, that you order another one. And you wanna get the OEM one here because, number one, it's strong. It's 10.9 grade, which means that the shear strength is really, really strong. And then also it's got a washer. Really, it's a cam for adjustability, though you will no longer adjust it from here with these adjustable tow arms. It gives you like an eighth of an inch of adjustability with the cams, but the washers fit this channel so that the bolt won't move. And you have a lot of force here with this tow arm, and that essentially means that if you tighten it with just a normal M12 washer, you could jar it loose and it could be sliding back and forth in this elongated hole. So you wanna get the stock bolt there. It's $35 or so for both. It's pretty expensive, I know, but it's worth it. And you can get those on eBay, you can get them from Tesla. There's a couple of other websites that sell them. So now we've got this together and we're gonna put everything back in. One change I did make, you'll notice earlier in the video, I actually had this, the ride height sensor peg installed backwards. So it was gonna be pointing that way. So I had to do it. This slopes down to clear the air suspension components. So I'm going to slide this in to the first side of the channel right here. Then I will grab my bolt. The slot that this camber arm goes in right here is a little smaller at the bottom, so it's hard to get it up this way. So what I have found is it moves. And so you can just kind of pull it out, come in from the top, and you're golden. I do want to point out the adjustment needs to be at the back. So you want this to kind of have the U-shape pointing down, but you want the adjustment in the rear because the technicians will remove the panel when they're doing the alignment and they'll come in from the bottom and have access to it here. If you put the adjustment on this side, they wouldn't have access to it. So now we'll put the tow arm in. What I'm gonna be doing now is I'm gonna be setting a baseline for the adjustment of the tow and the camber. That's just to get to the alignment shop because the alignment shop is gonna do the rest. So one more note before we start fast forwarding is to know what your torque specs are, very important. And so the torque specs for the camber arm are 103 foot-pounds for the rear bolt, and that's an 18 millimeter socket on both sides or wrench. And then, so that's 103 foot-pounds of torque. And then on this bolt down here, this is I believe it's a 15 millimeter. Let me see here. Yep, that's your 15 millimeter. So that one torques down to 96. On this one, connecting to the subframe, it's 85 foot-pounds of torque. And then connecting to the rear knuckle of the wheel assembly, it's 95 foot-pounds of torque. So 85, 95 or 96, 103 and 96. And the way you use a torque wrench, for those who don't have one, when you turn this, you adjust what the setting is for the torque. So right now, it's hard to see there, but right now it's on 80 foot-pounds. So there's a line right there and you can see 80, I'm on the zero. If I tighten it in, that's 82. If I move forward, I'm at 90. And if I'm gonna be doing the bolt in the rear first, which is what I'm gonna do for the camber arm, I'm gonna keep going. I'm at 92. So let's go back to zero. Now I'm at 100. And then I wanna go to 103. So now I'm at 103. Once you've got that there, you spin this in. Don't torque it down. It's just enough to keep it from moving. So now that's tight. And this will click whenever it gets to 103 foot-pounds of torque. So that means that we are at 103 foot-pounds of torque. So I'm gonna repeat that process for the rest of the nuts and bolts here, and enjoy the music while we go on fast forward. Last step here is to put the suspension ride height sensor back on the knuckle here. Takes a little bit of force. Oh. Ah, there we go. I will zip tie this to there once we get this thing set where we want it. So we're finishing up here. We have everything tightened down, torqued down, everything's good to go. And now we're getting our baseline reading before we go to the alignment shop. And so I have this TMR system, and basically what it's designed to do is you can measure it from both sides of the tires to set your toe, and then up and down, I'm using it with a level to see if we've got a good reading. So I've got my setting on very low, which is where I like to drive. I just think it looks better that way. And on very low, if you look here at this bubble, it's dead nuts even. And so this bubble is telling us right now that at my ride height, it is exactly where I want it to be. And so now we're gonna go and set the other side. Then we're gonna measure and make sure that our toe is pretty straight. All right, we are torquing down the very last of the lug nuts. Put the cover back on, and we are finished. So I would say that this is not for your amateur shop person. This is somebody who's probably more moderate, used to working on hot rods or used to working on cars in general. It's pretty complicated. It takes a minute to do. You have to understand the mechanics of the car and what you're doing in order to get it done right. But overall, I'm very excited. If you look, you can tell a big difference. The before and afters here, I'll try to put on the screen. It is, it's a world of difference on the left and the right side there. So, and it also hasn't been moved, so it'll settle in and it'll get a little bit better as it rolls. Thanks for watching, guys. And it's worth doing, whether you have somebody do it or whether you do it yourself. You definitely need to do the camber correction so that you stop wearing the inside edge of that tire out. I'm Tori Hornsby, Tesla Tips and Tricks, and we'll see you next time.